SQL Server 2019 Big Data Clusters provide data pools to optimize query performance when reaching out to multiple sources. UC is here with us today to tell us all about it, today on Data Exposed. Hi, and welcome to another episode of Data Exposed. I'm your host, Jeroen, and today we have UC with us to talk about data pools in SQL Big Data Clusters. Hi, UC, welcome to the show.
Hi, I'm happy to be here.
So, data pools in Big Data Clusters, what is it? What do I need to know?
Sure, yeah, let me quickly start by showing what a Big Data Cluster is. So this slide kind of shows a deployment of SQL Server 19 Big Data Cluster.
Okay.
And today we're going to talk about the data pools here, which are basically two SQL Server instances, which can be used to offload some query processing. Right?
Okay.
So let's see what is a data pool.
Mm-hmm.
So it's basically SQL Server storage and compute, which is provided to write queries and store data in the data pool, right? And it can be manipulated by running some external table operations on it, and you populate data into the data pool. And later you can actually offload some of your analytic queries over to this data pool, right? So that is the primary purpose of the data pool. So now let's maybe quickly take a look at some of the scenarios, right? So the common scenario is like you're getting data from different data sources. Some of them are fast, others are slower in nature. So now you want to basically optimize this query. So you could actually take that query and store the results in the data pool.
Mm-hmm.
And this allows you to basically use that like a staging area where you can run all your analytics. And the other example is like if you're doing machine learning,
right?
There are a lot of scenarios where you would generate features and hundreds and thousands of features. And you want to basically store the data set in a place where you can do repeated analysis.
Right.
And that's another place, yeah, where the data pool helps.
So in that case, it's not only for query optimization, but it's also for making sure you don't have to go back to the data source all the time, right?
Yes.
If you want to reuse the data.
Yeah.
Cool. That sounds very cool. So can you actually show us how this works?
Yep. Let's quickly go to SSMS here. So what I have here is a connection to the SQL Server Big Data Cluster. I am connected to the SQL Server Master instance. So the way to create a data pool is first by creating this data source object. So here, as this name indicates here, this basically says what type of a data source it is.
Mm-hmm.
And in this, I'm going to connect to a data pool.
Okay.
And that's how you create it. And after that, you define the table which you want to store in the data pool. And that's done by running this external table statement.
Okay.
And this looks like your regular create table statement. Mm-hmm. There are columns which you need to define. And in addition, since there are many SQL Server instances on the backend,
right,
you just need to say how you want to distribute the data.
So with this, you can tell, okay, so you know we get an even or approximately even distribution across across the servers.
Yes.
Okay.
So that's what the round robin does, is basically distributes the data across how many ever data pool instances you have.
Okay. Right.
And the next thing you can do is like, so query the data. So let's first look at some of the sample data, which in this example I have in a HDFS directory.
Mm-hmm.
And basically I want to take this clickstream data, do some query and populate into the data pool, right? And the way you would do it is by running just an insert statement. So the source of the insert statement is just a query, SQL query, right? And you can simply run the query and populate the data. I won't run through the inserts, but let's quickly see the data which is already populated in the data pool. So this query should return about 2,000 rows, right?
Mm-hmm.
So now it's just like any other table. You can actually join this table with other tables in your SQL Server and get the results. And transparently, this SQL Server instance is going to talk to the data pool instances to run the queries and get the results. So that's at a high level what a data pool is.
Cool. Awesome. That's very impressive. Thanks a lot, man.
Cool. Yeah. Thanks.
Okay. So thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. comment on the video if you want us to record something else, and hope to see you next time. Thanks.